Hey guys, Amos Johnson here. Come with a quick little faith chat. I want to talk about a substance requires honesty. But first, let's back up a little bit. Why am I talking about acceptance? Because remember, I've been talking these last few faith chats about the word for this year was those that know their calling, accepted, executed, will experience unprecedented levels of success. Now, part of those three things was of knowing, accepting, and executing was acceptance was in the middle. Now, in order to accept your calling, which means that God is speaking to your heart something, and you kind of sense, you kind of know this is what God is saying, you have to accept that this is what God is saying. And what holds a lot of us back from acceptance is honesty. Let me tell you what I mean by that. So say, for example, God has called you to quit your job and go start your own private school. Maybe you work as a principal at a current school right now, and you know in your heart, God has called you to step out, start your own school, but you got to be honest with yourself and say that I'm afraid that if I step out, this is not going to work. I'm afraid if I step out, I'm going to disappoint a lot of people that I'm currently working for, or I'm afraid of what my spouse may say about this decision. You see, God already knows your hangups. God already knows that you have some fear inside of you, but God can't help you overcome those things unless you're honest with him. He already knows your hangups, right? So in this private school example, if you're a principal or a private school and God is saying, step out and start your own thing, and you know that was God's call to do, you don't really need me to advise you and counsel. You know, in your heart, God is saying, leave this position and go start this thing over here. And you just got to be honest with yourself. Say, hey, I hear that in my spirit. I've been hearing that for a few years now. And really, God, what's holding me back is the fear of what if. What if it doesn't work? What if people say I'm a failure? What if my spouse, my kids don't understand it? What if the people that I'm currently working for now feel offended with me? What if? It's the fear of what if, what would happen. But how about this? What if you do step out? What if you do step out and this is the biggest private school in across America, across the world? What if you do step out and this is the best experience you ever had in your life? But you can't get to acceptance until you're honest about the fears that's holding you back from accepting the calling that God's placed in your heart. That's why I say most of us, we know what God has called us to do, but we're just afraid. And we got to be honest about the fear. God is not going to strike you down if you just be honest with him. He can help. He can succeed. There's a story in the New Testament about a father who had a son who's possessed by a devil. And he took the son to the disciples. The disciples couldn't cast him out. And he brought him to Jesus. And Jesus said, you know, I took him to his son. The dad said, I took him to your disciples. They can do it. And what Jesus said, if you have faith, all things are possible to you. But the father said something interesting. He said, Lord, I believe, but help my unbelief. So what he was saying was, God, I believe in what you're saying. I know that if I have faith, this can work, but I don't have it. And you know what Jesus did? He took that honesty of that father's heart and he healed his son. His father was honest about his lack of faith, honest about the fear that was holding him back. And God can do something with honesty, right? Honesty is the best breeding ground for faith. Your honesty and what you are afraid of is the best breeding ground to turn that fear into faith. So you already know what God has called you to do. You know he's called you to build that business, start that ministry, quit this job, do this thing, leave this relationship. Whatever it is for you, you know what it is. But be honest about the fear that's holding you back from accepting it. And when you're honest about the fear that's holding you back, man, now the skies are the limit. Now things are open up to you because now you're honest with yourself. God already knew you were afraid, but now God can work with that, turn that fear, help you turn that fear around, turn it into faith. And now you can accept what you already know to be true in your heart, that you're supposed to step out and do that particular thing. Hey guys, I pray this quick little faith chat was a blessing to you. As you know, we're starting ministry school next year, not next year, but next school year in September, but registration closed at the end of May. So if God has called you to be a minister and you know in your heart that he's speaking your spirit for you to join our ministry school, just go to churchofentrepreneurs.com/ministry and register today for ministry school. So that's churchofentrepreneurs.com/ministry. And finally, to close out, the Holy Spirit is speaking to you to partner financially with the Church of Entrepreneurs. Go to churchofentrepreneurs.com/partner. If you're already a partner, I want to thank you very much for your partnership, because your partnership allows us to minister. So during this pandemic, we can still minister because of your partners. So guys, I appreciate you guys as partners. So guys, you be blessed. Talk to you later. Be honest so you can turn that fear into faith. Talk to you later. Be blessed.